Hello everyone, this is Anuprati Devnath, the trainee under Lexus and Company for the month of June. So as you have already watched the title below what this video is all gonna be about, so let's get started. Now according to section 20 of the CPC says, other suits to be instituted where defendants resides or cause of action arises. Now this in simple terms means that defendant, specifically over here the section talks about the defendants. Now the place where the defendants resides physically as well as legally, because sometimes people do register their residence in some place and physically live in other place, so that shouldn't be there. So physically as well as legally stays in that particular place, according to the law, he will be a case will be filed against him in that jurisdiction, in any court in that particular jurisdiction. So let's come to the sections. What the section talks about: subject to the limitations aforesaid, every suit shall be instituted in a court within the local limits of whose jurisdiction. Means it should be within the local limits of particular jurisdictions over here. Clause A says the defendants or each of the defendants where there are more than one at the time of the commencement of the suit actually and voluntarily resides or carries on business or personally works for gain. Means the person is actually residing and actually potentially physically as well as legally residing in that place, as well as doesn't need to be his residing, his business, any other works, he just needs to be there, that's it. Clause B says any of the defendants where there are more than one at the time of the commencement of the suit actually and voluntarily resides or carries on business or personally works for gain, provided that in such case either the leave of the court is given or the defendants who do not reside or carry on business or personally work for gain as aforesaid acquaintance in such institution or. So basically it talks about that particular jurisdictions where he has to be given the proof of his residence. So number clause C says the cause of action wholly or partly arise, means the cause of action, like why did it happen, like why did the cause happen, why did the case happen, the crux or the reason of the case, so arises, so that should be there. And explanation 1 means according to the explanation it says where a person has a permanent dwelling at one place, means one person is dwelling in some particular place and also a temporary residence at another place, means he is legally dwelling in some place and actually residing in some other place, with both are different. He shall be deemed to reside at both places in respect of any cause of action arising at that place where he has such temporary residence. So basically he has to make papers for both his residence, that's it, for either temporary or permanent. The law provides both paperwork, so that needs to be cleared. So explanation 2, a corporation shall be deemed to carry on business as its sole or principal office in or in respect of any cause of action arising at any place where it has also subordinate office at such place. So that's it. Now let's come to an illustration that will make it very easy. Illustration number 1, A is a tradesman in Calcutta. B carries on business in Delhi. Now B buys his agent in Calcutta, buys goods of A and requests A to deliver them to the East Indian Railway Company. A delivers the goods accordingly in Calcutta. A may sue B for the price of goods either in Calcutta where the cause of action has arisen or in Delhi where B carries on business. Now that's what I just said. You can listen it up. I'll say about the thing is that when there is a business deal and the transaction happens in some other place and the order has been from some other place, so there you can, because it's a business deal, so you can sue both the company, the place, means the jurisdictions can be both different. Number B says, illustration number 2 says, A resides at Shimla, B at Calcutta and C at Delhi. A, B and C being together at Benares, B and C make a joint promissory note payable on demand and deliver it to A. A may sue B and C at Benares, where the cause of action arose. He may also sue them at Calcutta, where B resides, or at Delhi. There C resides, but in each of the cases, if the non-resident defendant objects, the suit cannot proceed without leave of the court. Means, if something happened in three different places, means the business location is in Delhi. Suppose the business location is in Delhi, you are residing in Calcutta, and the case happened in Benares. So where you will put the jurisdiction? So what's the jurisdictions? So normally, basically, it's better to provide three of the courts or three of the particular jurisdictions with three papers. Now, the main point is that the defendant can defend it that once the place where he is not residing, the court will always leave that case. Because he is not residing, why will they play or act on that case? Residing means his office, his tenure, his anything, he has to be staying over there for years or for something, for any purpose. So that's the case where will the case will be filed. It's better to file where the incident arose, and second is where he is residing, or where from where for what kind of case. It's a household case, then one file should be in where the case arose, where the incident arose, and on the second of all, file should also be held in his household areas. Now, like household jurisdiction, and if the case is professional, then his tenure office and that place. And also, it's provided in during the professional cases to provide one copy to that other court also. This is where he is residing. Now that's it with the illustration. Now let's come to the common questions according to under these sections. What people usually ask? So number one, where and in what place can a suit be instituted? So it says according to section 16 CPC, which deals with the cases of jurisdictions of competent courts. Now, where a suit, such suits can be instituted is basically, section 16 only provides. Now, in terms what general people will understand, it's that the jurisdiction, in their jurisdiction, so under the said provision, a suit can be instituted where the property is situated. That's it. No court other than the court where the property is situated can entertain such suit. Number two, how is the suit instituted? It says according to rule 1 of order 4 of CPC, says every suit shall be instituted by presenting a plaint in duplicate to the court or such officer as it appoints in its in this behalf. Now section 26 also provides that every suit shall be instituted by the presentation of a plaint or in such other manner as may be prescribed. Now number three, where does cause of action arise? Now the cause of action generally arises where the business deal is being appeared, or in civil cases where the property relating to the property the case happens over there. But then the jurisdiction according to where the jurisdiction will fall is in that area where the action occurred. Okay, so these were the three most common questions. Now let's take a bye. Thank you.